Actor Chadwick Boseman's death at the age of 43 certainly has a lot of people asking questions about the risk, about the incidence of colon cancer in young people. I'm Annie DeMout for the McGill University Health Center's MUHC-TV. So I'm joined by Dr. Barry Stein, who's the Director for Colon and Rectal Surgery at the MUHC, here with a little bit of advice on how you can protect yourself or perhaps somebody that you love. So first off, I want to address the idea that before Chadwick Boseman's tragic death, people may have thought of colon cancer as maybe an older person's cancer, but there seems to be a little bit of a shift in terms of who's affected. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, colon cancer is we start looking for it at about the age of 50. And when you look at the graph, it's really age 50 onwards up into the 80s, and it's a pretty straight line. Now, we do know that there is a trend that's occurring in getting younger age group. And we know this younger age group has been getting colon cancer, and that's been on a steady rise now for going on for quite a while. No one really understands it. We looked at things like obesity and sedentary lifestyle and eating processed meats. Of course, we have genetic history, ulcerative colitis, but there seems to be in this category that we don't really understand is why is this going up in this age group? So we want to remind everyone that if you have a change in bowel habits, if you see blood in your stool, if you have unexplained abdominal pains, that you should come and get checked.
Is part of the issue that young men sort of can't believe this might be an issue, and so they ignore some of these symptoms for a prolonged period of time. So by the time they do come to you, perhaps we're dealing with a case that's a little bit more severe or advanced. Is that part of the issue?
Well, it's interesting. So it's possible. We know that certainly if you have a person that's older, let's say a 40-year-old that's having some bleeding, they see their family doctor or their friends and they think, oh, this is just my hemorrhoids that are bleeding. And we certainly see over at the Center for Colorectal Surgery at the MUHC, we see a couple of patients every year that had that and they thought it was just their hemorrhoids, or even their family doctor thought it was their hemorrhoids that were bleeding, which is by far the most common thing to occur in that age group. But it's not, it's cancer. And there's a very simple procedure of looking inside the rectum that we do in the office, even with no sedation, and we can make the diagnosis very quickly. And the important thing is, the earlier the diagnosis, the better the survival will be. We know we can come to very high survival rates in stage one colon cancer.
And what about people with family histories? How does the screening work for them?
We look at the blood relatives, brothers, sisters, mothers, fathers. And we know that you, as the person who's interested, should always be checked a minimum of 10 years before that relative first presented with a polyp or their cancer. So 10 years beforehand. So let's say your dad had it at the age of 55, you're coming at 45 to get checked. And a big thing you mentioned about guys not getting checked, this is a disease that affects men and women overall fairly equally. So this is not a man's disease, it's not a woman's disease, it's everyone's disease.
Don't delay if you have any symptoms or you're due for an appointment. It's safe.
That's right. And people, please don't stay home because of COVID. We are seeing now that as things are opening up, people were staying home and saying, oh, I had this symptom, but I didn't want to come in. Our hospitals are very safe for COVID, certainly at the McGill University Health Center. And we strongly recommend that if you have symptoms, please don't wait. If you have a symptom, come get a check so we can take care of you and fix the problem.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, Dr. Stein.
My pleasure.